Here are 9 features inside of Canva you will wish you knew earlier. The first is Magic Write. Magic Write is basically ChatGPT inside of Canva. But the advantage of this is you have all the text editors you need to edit the text you generate from Magic Write. So let's say you are writing an email or a blog post, or you are creating a CV. With Magic Write, after generating the text, you now have these editing tools on Canva that you can use to edit your text and then export it either as a PDF file or whichever format you want to have it. To access Magic Write, just open Canva, then click on Docs. Here, start a new writing project. That will open a blank document workspace for you. You can either decide to start typing what you want to type manually, or you can just click on this plus icon and then select Magic Write and then type in what you want Magic Write to help you write. Maybe I could say something like, write an article on the awesomeness of the pyramids of Egypt. Then click on enter. Magic Write is going to use the prompt you've entered to generate the text you want. One thing about this is the more detailed you are with your prompt, the better output you are going to get. And once you have the text you need, you can change the font type if you want, change the font size, and do all of this normal editing stuff you would usually do. And once you are done, you can just go ahead to share and download as a PDF file. You can basically ask this AI to write anything you want. Maybe you want to write a letter, you can just come over, click on Magic Write, and then write an application letter for the host of an organic marketing manager. And Magic Write is going to help me write a full letter here. You can just go through it, change whatever you need to change in this letter, and you have it ready for use. The next feature is flipping books. If you need to create flipbooks, you can now do that easily inside of Canva with just a click of a button. Let's say I want to turn this project into a flipbook, for instance. Just click on share and then click on more and then search for flipping book. Here's flipping book, click on it, and then select the pages you would want to use. I'm going to use all the pages, click on done, and then click on save. At this stage, you'll be required to create a new flipping book account. You can just do that very easily, either with your Google account or your email address. So I'm going to click on view in flipping book, then log into my flipping book account. And with that, we have a nice flip book right here. And this is very cool. If you want to share, you can either click on share to get the link that you can share with your readers, or you can just embed it on your website. Also, you have some tools here that you can use to edit your flipbook. Another feature that Canva added recently is called text to image. And this feature uses AI to convert your text prompts into images. This is like the Canva version of Midjourney. Start a new Canva project, then come over to where you have apps, and then you'll find text to image right here. Click on it, then you can enter your text prompt that you want to generate an image from. So let me type in watercolor painting of 3 lions. You can type in anything you want and then click on enter. And now we have these different images right here that you can add to the design you are creating. Let's say none of these images suit you. You can click on create again. Let me try another prompt. I'll type in portrait of the Garden of Eden and then click on enter. So here you have it. With this text to image feature, you can use AI to create images of anything you can imagine. Anytime you want to remove the background from an image, you can do that very easily in just one click using the background remover feature on Canva. And this feature also works for videos as well. Let's say I want to remove the background from this image. Just select it, then click on edit image. Then you see this background remover. Just in case you can't find it at the top here, you can just search for maybe remover and you are going to see it. Just click on it. And with just one click, I've been able to remove the background from my image. Sometimes it doesn't do it perfectly, so you can either use this erase or restore tool depending on what you need to do to perfect the process. Once you are done, click on apply and then you can proceed to use this in your designs. Just like the background remover, you can also save high quality PNG images with transparent backgrounds on Canva. With this feature, you can create designs that you can use on other projects without worrying about the background. So I have this simple design here, and let's say the only thing I need from this design is this object I have on it. So I don't want the background. I can go ahead and save by clicking on share, then click on download, select PNG, select the size you want to use, then check transparent background. With this, your image is going to download without the background. So I'm going to select the page, then just go ahead and click on download. And if I open this down, download, you are going to see that the final product we have here does not have any background. Another very interesting feature that Canva has been working on recently is called Face Retouch. And with this feature, you can basically enhance human faces on images inside of Canva. You can also smoothen faces, whiten teeth, or change eye color to red using Face Retouch in Canva. I have this image here, for instance. So just click on it and then click on Edit Image. This time, you want to look for Face Retouch. If you can find it at the top here, just search for Face Retouch and you are going to see it. Click on it. You could decide to use Auto, but I'm going to reduce the Auto function to 0. Then you can come over to Smooth Skin. If you want to make the skin of your subject a little bit smoother, you can increase or reduce the intensity as well, depending on what you want. You can also come over to whiten teeth. This is going to whiten the teeth of your subject. You can increase the intensity or reduce it depending on the one that suits you, or you could also use the red eye feature. Once you are done with all of this, you can just click on apply. Another cool thing you can do in Canva is branding. So if your business has custom colors, fonts, and all of that, and you want to have them reflect on your designs, Canva makes that very, very easy for you. When you open Canva, come over to brand. Here you see the brand that you are currently using. You can add a new brand, upload your brand logo, brand colors, brand fonts. And once you add all of that here, they are going to show up for you whenever you are creating your design. So if you want to add a brand color, for instance, you can just click on this plus icon under colors and then either use the slider here or enter the color code for your brand. And with that, I have a new color right here. So if I'm creating a new design and I want to use my custom color as the background of my design, click on background color and then you're going to see the color that I've added. Another thing you can do is to copy the code of your color. And if you are searching for elements, images, videos, animations, and all of that, come over to element and then let me search for book, for instance. You can click on this filter icon and then paste in the code of your color, click on apply, and then click on apply filters. You are going to see that all the results Canva will give you will match the color of your brand. One Canva feature I've been using a lot lately is presentation. Aside from the fact that you can use Canva to create your slides, you can also present to different platforms like Zoom, Instagram, directly from inside Canva, or you can even present and record your presentation at the same time, all in Canva. Open Canva, select presentation, look for a template that you like, and then prepare your slides. Once your slide is ready and it's time for presentation, you can just click on present. You are going to see different options here: present full screen, present preview, present and record. This if you want to record your presentation, and autoplay. Just select the one that you would want to work with and then start your presentation. It's that easy. Just in case you want to create a very simple website, maybe like a link in bio website, right now you can do that very easily inside of Canva for free. To create your website, you can just open Canva, then use the search box, search for website, and then I'm going to select this. Here you'll find different website templates that you can use. I'm going to use this, for instance, then click on customize this template, and then go ahead and do all the editing you need to do. It's very easy. You just need to use the editing tools that you usually use on Canva. Once you are done, click on publish website, check resize on mobile so that your website will be mobile responsive, and then you can publish your website without navigation or with navigation, depending on the one you prefer. Then you can either publish to free domain, purchase a new domain, or use a domain you already own. I'm going to use a free domain, for instance, and then click on continue. Then you can enter your subdomain name. Here you can see a little notification. You can edit your subdomain later in domain settings. After you are done, this domain is not available. Once you find one that's available, click on continue. This is your website URL. You can enable password protection or hide your website from search engines. Once you are done doing all of this, just click on publish. You can copy your website URL and paste it wherever you want. You can also click on view website to see what your website is going to look like. This is what the website Canva created looks like, and this is very, very impressive. That's all for this video, guys. Before you go, please hit the like and subscribe buttons. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.